in.
Heaps of mail to get through today. I've been busy with family over Christmas. Let's have a look. These are mini breadboards, and they're almost like Lego. In fact, I think the principle's basically the same, except applied to small breadboards. And I'll be using these for little practice circuits I want to do with 5-5 timers. 5-5-5 timers, I should say. That sort of thing. And here they are. So there's a little baseboard which is about 150 by 100 mils or 6 by 4 inches. There's 7 mini breadboards which I think are 5. Appear to be 60 point, and as you can see, they're a bit like Lego on the back, so we just plug it in, and there we go. I'm looking forward to having a bit of a play with those, so I'll set them aside. I think I know what this is, but oh no, it's not what I thought. Ah, finally, I have been waiting ages for these. These are 18650 flat top batteries. Now you've got to be careful with 18650s in particular, because this is not an 18650, but to give you an example, this has got the little button head that you can see here, which is standard on most batteries, but 18650s also, and other batteries may too, I don't know, but these also come in a flat top. You can see there's no raised button, they're flat at both ends, and the reason I want these is to fit into these power banks, which you saw in a previous video. If I can get the bugger open, really. Geez, it'd be nice if something went easier for a change. Oh, I'm going to wreck that if I try and get it out. But anyway, four 18650 batteries. Don't know what this is. You're not really going to be able to see them there, but they are seeds for a succulent, a pig face succulent called Coastal Pig Face. Got a little, I'm in a rental at the moment, but just got a little area I want to freshen up, so that's what those are for. My God, there's a lot of mail here. Oh, finally. This is from AliExpress and took... Oh, it might have been Timo. But it took bloody forever. This is a quick nozzle for blowtorch. Oh, I don't seem to have any gas handy just this minute, but on standard gas butane cans that clips on top. I sometimes use this to burn out mailing labels, particularly when I go to the tip, but also sometimes for cooking. Yeah, I won't go into the cooking. This is not a cooking channel. Now, this is an Australia Post bag, but the way it's packed, I'm suspecting it's from Timu. And the way it looks inside would certainly make me think that. Yes, this is Timo. So what we have here is a floating feeding cup for fish to feed them live worms. Has a suction cap, help it hold on at the back. This is for my son. I've already got one of these myself. These are really clever. People with mustaches and beards. Basically, it's a Velcro bib. You put it around your neck, you use these two suction hooks to put the other in the mirror, and it catches all the shit that comes off when you're trimming your beard, which is a real hassle to clean up. With these, it takes me about 2 seconds. I take it out the backyard, I shake it up. Good night, Irene. Oh, okay, these are, I guess you'd call them tool hangers. I've got these to put just inside my garage door to put brooms and things on. I think I've ordered 4 from memory, but we'll see. Yep, there's another 2. Holy hell. Don't know what that is. Now we have a box. Oh, I ordered 6 of those. Something else in here, I think. No. No, that's it. Let's see what's in the box. Yes, this is just a basic, well, I guess you'd call it a trinkets box, jewelry box, something like that. Basically, I just wanted somewhere to throw my keys when I come home. I'm regularly having to go into hospital for MRIs, and I have to remove all metal before I go. So, you know, I can throw my watch in here, and my earring if I'm wearing one, and get any other metal. I don't remember what I paid for it, or no, it was very little. Nice little catch there. And we open it up. Ah, that's quite nice. I like that. Holy shit, what's this? Oh, yeah. Here's a Temu package. This one was sent from within Australia. They have a warehouse here now. First thing I can see is black, I think Americans call this egg crate. In reality, it's meant to be a fluorescent light diffuser. But we use them in aquariums as, you know, dividers and to hold things up. We make coral stands out of them, all sorts of things. And black is very hard to get in Australia. That's just a large air stone for the tank. What's this? These are candle wicks, and I've bought them as replacements to go into my floating candles. Oh, that's a super ugly watering can. Hang on, let me open it. That's for watering my indoor plants. What do we got here? This bag's half full of suction caps, and then these are really hard to get. Well, not impossible, but not easy to find in Australia. Now, what they're actually meant for is you're meant to, they go together like that, and they're a clip, and they're actually for aquariums, and you put, you know, slices of veggie or nori or whatever on there. But what I use them for is I have a disabled parking permit, and they are shits to display in the right place. So stick that on the windscreen, angle it down, put the card in there, Bob's your uncle. Now, if anyone wants to buy one of these off me, because they are hard to find, just contact me, leave a comment, something like that, and I will send you one, happy to send you one for cost plus postage. Or if you happen to be in the Gippsland area of Victoria in Australia, you can probably even come and pick it up. Knowing me, I will probably end up giving most of these away to people I see in adjoining disabled car parks. But, yeah, anyway, they are excellent. Oh, what have we got here? Ah, more aquarium stuff. These are planter rings, so for stem plants, you'll see these better when I show you where I bought them, but you pop the stem down through the hole. This helps weight them down. Over time, these deteriorate, I would think over a couple of years, and it helps hold the plant in place while the roots grow into the soil underneath. Don't know why I've bought two blue ones of these, but I've got two black ones. No, these are not what I thought. Hang on. Ah, I know what these are. I thought these were mobile phone holders, because I have one in my car that looks very similar and actually works really well, but here we go. What these actually are plant holders. So you hang them on the side of your tank, you pop the plant down through there, and this is for putting in terrestrial plants that you want the roots in the water to take up detritus, and then the rest of the leaves are out of the water. For things like aluminium plant, ivy, papyrus, lots of plants anyway. So that's what that's for. I've got four. Don't know why I bought four of them. I've got six. Don't know why I did that. Oh my god, I've got eight. I had to have made a mistake there, I think. Okay, that's gone. Getting a bit crowded here, isn't it? We're only about halfway through. I was told this didn't get sent, but it obviously did. I'm decorating my stud. I'm decorating around the house in general. I guess I like the bad girls, and yeah, I would love to spend 7 days with Lindsay Lohan locked in a room. Well, they've sent me two. Oh, I see. One hasn't worked. Anyway, that's lovely. I'm happy with that. Clues on the outside. Oops. There you go. Jesus. Well, it's well packed, whatever it is. This is kind of a Viking plaque for the wall. I'm descended from Vikings. On the mount. It's pretty heavy. I did, from the same place, I did buy a, I can never remember the name of it, but an altar piece. You would use it in a Viking altar for decoration. It was that shape. I can't quite think what they're called, but it's a Norse hammer. However, while that looked nice, it had a rounded bottom, so you couldn't stand it. And it had no way of mounting it. So at least this is a mounting area. Yeah, I quite like that. What else do we have? Oh, down to about the last five. In this one. no weight to it. Electronic components. I'll give you a better look when I show you where I bought them. I think these are tremble switches, so they pass current when they get knocked or anything. Similar to a tilt switch that might be used on a pinball machine, but these are purely digital. Let's see what's in the box. Actually, no, it's a bit of a relief to get through all this mail so I can leave appropriate feedback. And yeah, a couple of my kids are waiting on me to make power banks for them, for which I just got the battery. Plus I'm getting low on them myself. I tend to, people visit and their phones are flat and they don't realise until they're going, so I give them a power bank. Usually tell them to keep it. No, they cost me about $5, no big deal. And it's good to help people out. Although, I'm sure most people would rate me as a genuine credited arsehole, but, I'm an arsehole that stops to help people who are broken down on the side of the road. Both my son and I, we're both firefighters. Well, I can no longer firefight because of my health, but we're both highly trained volunteer firefighters. Oh, these are some aquarium. No, they're not. Ah, this is a pan and tilt mechanism for a little ESP32 camera module. Oh, gee, that was really overpacked. What else we got here? So these will be from eBay, I think. What do we got? This is a little electronic beetle kit. Cheap as chips. But it takes a little coin cell battery, and I'm going to put it together for my almost 3-year-old granddaughter, and yeah, when she touches it, it will flash lights, and I thought it made a sound too, but I'm not so sure now. I can't see a sound module, although I can put one on. Oh, what else do we have? Oh, this feels soft. I think. No, I don't think. That's why my brain was dipped. Okay, what are we? Oh, okay. I do know what this is. This is a cheap little bamboo. Guess you'd call it, in reality, a coaster, but what I want it for is to go under a particular plant pot I have. So. else we got down here? Oopsie daisies. Oh, I think I'll be clearing up my desk when I finish it up. More aquarium stuff. These are algae wafers for fish that rely on algae. Also the shrimp. Got one. Lucky I scrounged around, and there I had dropped that in the bin. Oh, let's have a look at this one. This is for my granddaughter as well. What this is a battery-operated, programmable LED name badge, and I mean, yeah, she'll be three in next month, and I'm pretty sure she'll get a kick of running around with this pin on her jacket. It's blue. No, I won't take it out yet. Yeah, a little bit of weight to it, so I don't know how practical it's going to be. As a name badge, we'll see. Maybe I'll have to put it on and say, hello, granddaughter. Yes, I'd use her name, but I'm not giving her name on the internet. Have a look. I think these might be more 18650 batteries. Rather fancy packaging. Big for 18650. Hang on, I just had an 18650. Let me. No, that's not it. Where did I put it? There they are. Oh yes, they are 18650. These are supposedly 2500 milliamp hour. These are supposedly 'Cause doesn't really matter what they say, because it's usually fake anyway, but these are supposed to be, it doesn't say, but I'll fully charge all those and then discharge them through a load that I have, put a USB doctor in between and find out their true capacities over time. In case you weren't aware, most brand new rechargeable batteries cannot hit their capacity on the first charge. They need a few charge cycles to do that. Oh, and these, I think, yes, these are more electronics. These are resistor arrays. So when you've got, come on, open up. Oh, tape on there. Well, I'll show you these when I show you where I bought them. That's way easier. Okay. Thanks for bearing with this really... Let's try that again. Thank you very much if you've watched through this far in the video. Please leave a like, and what really helps is a comment, even if you want to tell me I'm a dill, that helps. Yeah, so you have a good one.
Please like.